Greetings to all of you. A warm welcome to all of you in this Christmas season. I'm giving you the epiphany that was related to last Sunday, so yesterday. For some already are in their evening, Monday evening. For some are in their early morning. That depends where the sun goes up and down. Starstruck. This is your Pastor Yeti. And I give you the readings, Isaiah 60, verse 1 to 6, Ephesians chapter 3, verses 2 to 3, 5 and 6, and then Matthew chapter 2, verses 1 to 12. We saw a star at its rising and have come to him to bring him worship. Reflection. What star? Speculations about scientific and otherwise. What we do know that ancient belief considered a new star the signal of a new king's birth. Did that belief draw the Magi to Palestine in quest of the new king of the Jews? Too little to know about them for us to say. But Matthew's gospel does say they were starstruck. Today's English phrase means captivated by famous people or by fame itself. It dates only to the 60s, but the Magi certainly knew what it meant to be struck, fascinated, and driven by the new star they thought announced the birth of a new king in distant Israel. Though no one knows quite why, that experience somehow feels familiar. We also know what it means to be smitten, dazzled, and drawn by an English royal couple or the latest movie star, without quite being able to explain why. That light stabs and draws us, whether we will it or not. And perhaps it's been because light attracts us toward its source when we ourselves are in the dark, either physically or metaphorically. It offers a focus for wonders, clarity for the confused, and the unspoken promise of warmth, safety, and company still lodged in a primal memory of huddling together around campfires while predators roamed outside. Wolves and lions no longer walk our streets, but unseen forces greater than ourselves do. And they do not seem to be friendly. Whether you enjoy the widely popular superhero sagas or laugh them out, they do speak loudly of cultural fears that can no longer be stilled by confidence in a God who surrounds and protects us with guardian angels. Those beliefs have died for many, but the fears have not. Sudden unexplained attracts of violence in what once seemed safe places, like schools, workshops, and houses of worship, have only stoked those fears. The birth of the light of the world, singled by one singularly bright star traveling ahead to lead seekers to the place, still steers at least a moment's hope, even for many whose religious beliefs are only embers. To believers, it offers the promise of the Savior who came into the frightening darkness of a world ruled by sin and death to carry us into the unquenchable light no darkness can ever again extinguish. our meditation. Did you or do your children insist on a nightlight? What fears sparked it? Why did the light give a sense of safety? Pray with me. O God of light and darkness, send us a star to guide us to the safety you only can give. Amen. The star was leading the wise man to the town Bethlehem and stopped there. And they prostrate themselves for Jesus and give him the gold, which related to a kingship. Frankincense to divinity and mirth to suffering. The star was guiding them and then disappeared. What is the star that struck you, that guides your life to a certain different direction? And do you allow yourself that the light of Christ is your guidance? Because Christ is the light of the world. May God bless you. This is your Pastor Yeti. Bye.